Chapter 3. What the heck are you doing? I soon awoke to find myself not at Marcus Brody High School, but on a plane. Now, don't try to rewind anything, partly because I was unconscious at the time, and because I didn't write down anything in the last two chapters that would explain how I got from one place to the other. Moving on. So, I soon got my surroundings set. I was on some sort of cargo plane, and I was laying on some crates with some pillows. So great. Now I've been kidnapped, and there was only one person I could think of doing an act like this. I stumbled to my feet, and I marched right up to the part of the plane that I thought was the cockpit. And sure enough, there he was, Flynn Carson. Flynn? What the heck are you doing? Kidnapping? I never thought you would stoop to a level as bad as this. I told you I was all for another adventure, but this is crossing so many lines. Not to worry, not a person will know you were gone. Besides, don't you want to know how I got you out of school? Curses, he was right. I did want to know that. I have to remember to stay focused in the future. Yeah, how'd you do it? You wouldn't think I'd leave the library without bringing and using something magical from there. What I had you hold for me was the Orb of Confusion. It's a lost treasure I picked up while trying to discover some lost secrets of Atlantis. Turns out that it was an ancient pearl that when one holds it, okay, I get it. Actually, I was very confused. And that's not the orb talking. Why Flynn was basically kidnapping me. He and I both knew that my knowledge of history was good, but he didn't need me on this adventure. Well, maybe. Maybe if adventure is in the agreement, then maybe I would be willing to oblige. So, where are we heading to, if I had to guess? Look out the window. I then wandered over to a nearby window and saw the rolling hills of Ireland. It was beautiful. Really, it was. The ground below was lush and green. And when I say green, I mean the color, not the environment garbage. Which, I suppose is an oxymoron when you think about it. When people speak of the environment, they usually want to keep it clean. However, I said environment garbage, so get it? Oh, forget it. Sorry, way off topic. I then returned to Flynn's side. I never knew you were a pilot. You know how to land, too, right? Fly? Yes. Land? No. Huh. My great-grandfather said something very similar to my great-great-grandfather once. I saw through the windshield that we were approaching a runway. Flynn eased on the joystick, and the plane started heading down. I then grabbed the stick too, to help him. The plane was starting to get closer and closer to the ground. I then pulled the wheels lever, and they lowered. We somewhat landed gently on the runway, and maneuvered the plane to a parking place. I wiggled through the plane to the door, which was in the back. I turned the handle, and the door flew open. Flynn was right behind me, and we exited the plane. I couldn't believe that I was actually standing in Ireland. My mother had been wanting me to go there for my entire life. I mean, I have family here, both my parents and I appreciated the music and dance of the country, and a lot of other things that if I were to write them all down, I would start to ramble and that would be the end of the book. Moving on. We went through the airport, did the airport stuff, and continued on the way to find St. Patrick's Cross.